Have you ever thought about adding an apartment above your garage or converting your basement into a living space for a family member? These living spaces are called accessory dwelling units, essentially a second dwelling unit on a single residential property. Right now, you can't build accessory dwelling units in Salem, but the city is looking at allowing them as a way to expand housing choices in the community. To better understand the issues and opportunities that come with this type of housing, the city formed a Housing Choices Advisory Committee. The committee includes two city councilors, three planning commission members, neighborhood association representatives, and representatives from the development and design community. The committee will develop recommendations for preview at a community open house before recommending a package to council early next year. For more on what accessory dwelling units are and why we're talking about this now, we turn to South Gateway Neighborhood Association representative Sylvia Machado, serving on the committee.
An accessory dwelling unit, or ADU, is really an addition to the current property. It could be over a garage, it could be a conversion of one existing house, it could be an addition to the house, even a detached dwelling in the back. This would not include RVs or motorized vehicles or tiny houses on wheels. It would just be a traditional stick-built addition. The city did a study about 2 years ago that showed that in about 20 years, it's going to be very deficient in multi-housing properties. And so we're hoping to ease the restrictions a little bit so that people can add these ADUs to their properties. Well, some of the benefits of this is, let's say you have an aging parent who needs a place to live but doesn't want to live in the main house. Or you have kids, you know, staying after they finish college, they're staying home, or they're coming back home, and this would be an alternative for them. Some of the challenges of allowing these are, you want to make it so that it doesn't impose on the parking. That could be a challenge. Also the detail, the design of it. You want it to be aesthetic so it doesn't, you know, look out of context with the neighborhood. So far, our committee is very supportive of ADUs and hope to relax the restrictions somewhat so that more people can look at that alternative multifamily housing. I think the committee is made up of a good mix of people. We've got builders and business owners and community members, and I think that we'll be able to come to a really good consensus and have a good package to submit.
Have more questions? Sit in on an upcoming Housing Choices Advisory Committee meeting or contact planner Eunice Kim.